The M1 MacBook Pro has been in my hand for the last 7 months, and I'm pretty confident to say that I know this guy pretty well. So in this video, I want to share to you my experience while working with it as my main computer during 7 months, and some of the issues that you could expect if you select this model, and finally, should you buy it. Since Apple released the new M1 MacBook in November 2020, I was overwhelmed with many informations about the new Apple computer. So it's come with 8-core CPU, 16 billion transistor, and its battery life can last up to 20 hours, which is mind-blowing. It's likely double the performance than the latest MacBook Pro 2020 that used the Intel chip. And the craziest thing is, its price is 700 cheaper than the old one. So first off, let's talk about the performance. I mainly use these computers for editing videos and graphic design works like Photoshop and Illustrator for the past 7 months, and I can confirm that it's worked incredibly smooth. Never experienced any crash while running application on these computers. I bought this computer in December 2020, and at that time, the majority of apps that I just mentioned are not native yet with the new chip. However, it's still running pretty well, and you can't even notice if it's run under the Rosetta 2. So the good news is native apps for the M1 chip are updated every day, so now we have Photoshop, Lightroom, Illustrator, Microsoft Office, and many other apps that you can proactively check on this website. This computer can do more than just a working machine. It may sound crazy to you, but I actually tried to play CSGO in its full resolution on this computer, and the performance is just great. If you want to see that in detail, check the video in the description. So to condense this section, I would say the performance of the M1 MacBook Pro is exceptional, and for me, I don't feel any limits while working with it. Now let's talk about the MacBook display. So the MacBook comes with a 30-inch Retina display, which gives you the accurate color, and its price list is 500 nits, which is a good idea if you want to bring it to work outside. To be honest, I don't feel it's big enough for me while I'm doing like editing stuff. However, if you just do web browsing or office job, I think 30-inch is an ideal size when you don't want to carry a large and heavy computer daily to work. Now let's talk about the most impressive update that I like about this computer, which is battery life. So Apple claimed that this MacBook Pro can last up to 20 hours when you do web browsing. To be honest, I can't test that long, but it actually lasts for me like 8 hours when I'm doing web browsing with Chrome and also connect with external display. So that way I did consume more power than usual. So let's say if you do office job and just simple tasks, like 8 hours a day, so you probably don't have to charge your computer for about 2 days. So it's totally changed my experience. I don't like to carry a large and heavy laptop chargers everywhere I go. And also, it's just annoying if you have to recharge your laptop every freaking 5 hours. Now let's talk about the microphone, speakers, and webcam. So the voiceover you are hearing right now is directly from the MacBook Pro microphone. In my opinion, it is good. Actually, it was better than my old external USB microphone. It's delivered more bass and accurate on my voice. The speaker is not really loud when compared to my last 2017 Retina MacBook, but still deliver the good sound quality. Everything is good until I see the webcam. I actually disappointed a bit because the picture is pretty noisy and blurred. And seriously, Apple, this video quality doesn't look like 720p. Did you miss anything? Just like other newest MacBook models, Apple did not put the butterfly keyboard on these new computers, which is great. Instead of that, we have the magic keyboard that gives you much more responsiveness feel whenever you're typing, and it's pretty quiet. Now let's talk about the touch bar. I personally don't like it because I prefer the physical keyboard. It's giving you more feel, more response whenever you touch it, rather than on the bar and you feel like nothing. However, I did something to make it more useful than just a regular touch bar, so you can play games on it, for example. If you wonder how I made this, make sure to check the video in the description. So far, everything is great until I faced with this critical error that I didn't know why. So one day, like every other days, I was surfing on the internet and my screen crashed and looked like this. About like 3 seconds later, it's auto rebooted the computers. So I've been using this computer for about 7 months and this error did happen twice. I did a quick search and I'm not alone. A lot of people are actually facing the same problem as me and didn't find what was the problem. Hopefully Apple will fix this error in the upcoming software update. So just like other computers out there, it's not 100% perfect. And I just want to give you the accurate information about what should you expect from this computer when you decide to buy it. Should I recommend you to buy it? Well, I would say it mostly depends on what you plan to do with this computer. First of all, there are some niche applications that are not working or optimized on the M1 chip yet. And let's say you have to rely on those apps to work. So in that scenario, I recommend you not to. However, if your work app is just not optimized yet for the new chip, you can still buy it. As I mentioned, all the Intel apps are still work well under the Rosetta 2, and 99% of your app will be updated in the future. So I let you decide by yourself. Just please tell me your options, your reason in the comment below. And before you leave, please do me a quick favor. Subscribe to this channel to receive more videos like this. I really appreciate you watching until this, and thanks for watching, and see you on the next video.